So, first of all, again, allow me to express my gratitude to Libe for allowing me this opportunity and for all the questions and interest shown to what for Greece is an issue of cardinal importance. I hope that is an issue of cardinal importance for the whole of Europe. I would have picked as a choice to answer each question by itself, but the time frame does not allow me to do that, so please allow me to provide you with what we consider a summarized answer on the whole issue.
Συνοπτική, ας δώσουμε μια συνοπτική απάντηση σε όλα τα θέματα.
Το περασμένο Ιανουάριο υποσχεθήκαμε
στην Ευρωπαϊκή Ένωση ένα σχέδιο δράσης.
That action plan was consisted of a first reception center that is up and running as we speak, with a new asylum system that is up and running as we speak, with a new appeals authority that is up and running as we speak, and with a returns policy that is there and is being implemented as we speak.
Η επιστροφών, η οποία εφαρμόζεται αυτή τη στιγμή που μιλάμε.
I have been asked about old pre-removal centers, especially by Mr. Mulder, who was in Athens with members of this committee. Please allow me to answer such that the pre-removal centers that this committee has visited, except for one, do not exist anymore. Vena has been closed. All Hellenicon has been closed. The old the new Hellenicon which we have visited, as you have visited, it does not exist anymore. It has been refurbished and it is going to be closed by the end of 2013.
Now,
what is the issue facing up on the old asylum cases that have been asked, on the backlog
from
first cleared means that those cases, there is no interest from the party involved to try them anymore. From the remaining cases, 3,606 have been tried, and I have to say the rate of international protection that was given is 25.28%.
So, το ποσοστό διεθνούς προστασίας που έχει δοθεί είναι 25.28%.
On the issue of Turkey, I have to say Turkey is trying to change, but on the other hand, we are not receiving the support we are expecting. We have submitted to Turkey in 2012 almost 25,000 readmission petitions, and please allow me to say that only 113, and I repeat the number, 113 were readmitted.
Από όλα αυτά τα άτομα τα δέχτηκε η Τουρκία πίσω.
There is an issue of financial difficulties we are facing.
Φυσικά let me give you the figures. Δυσκολιών.
The budgeting, I will give a copy to the committee in the electronic form so that all of you could have access to the individual figures. But the total cost of the new plan on a per year basis is almost 500 million euros.
Είναι
for
περίπου
that, almost 250 million,
247
have been provided by the Greek budget. The European contribution is 178 million euros.
We are grateful,
but it's less than Greece itself provides for the illegal migration issue at this time of the hugest financial constraint in the Greek history. And there is a gap of 72 million remaining.
Και μας λείπουν 72 εκατομμύρια. Μιλήσαμε με την Επιτροπή.
I have to say that the Commission proposes us to use. We have absorbed all the solid funds. The Commission proposes to use the structural funds.
Και τώρα μας προτείνει η Κομισιόν να χρησιμοποιήσουμε τα διαφορετικά ταμεία.
Are allocated on a prefecture basis. So it is very difficult for us to use them. We are trying our best to do that, especially for helping vulnerable groups. We're trying our best, but I'm afraid financing is not sufficient. Let me finish with something that for us is of cardinal importance. Relocation. Ladies and gentlemen, whatever do we do, it has to be discussed between us as Europeans that in the end, some people have to be relocated.
Ό,τι και να κάνουμε, κάποιοι όμως πρέπει να πρέπει να εγκατασταθούν. Εμείς είμαστε μια χώρα 10 εκατομμύρια ανθρώπων. Δεν μπορούμε να απορροφήσουμε
500-600-700
λαθρομετανάστες. Όπως η Γερμανία δεν μπορεί να απορροφήσει 10 εκατομμύρια λαθρομετανάστες.
We need Europe to see clearly to the problem, to see clearly to the issue, and open what is a question that should have been opened a long time ago.
Mr. Chairman,
Mr. President, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to address the leader
committee.
Ήταν για μένα σήμερα μια μεγάλη ευκαιρία να ενημερώσω την Επιτροπή ΛΥΠΕ, την Επιτροπή Εσωτερικών Υποθέσεων του Ευρωπαϊκού Κοινοβουλίου, για το ελληνικό action plan που αφορά τη μετανάστευση και το χειρισμό των παράνομων μεταναστευτικών ροών. Και κυρίως να ζητήσω την βοήθεια και τη συνεργασία του Ευρωπαϊκού Κοινοβουλίου και των Ευρωβουλευτών σε αυτό που για την Ελλάδα είναι ένα θέμα επιβίωσης, δηλαδή την αντιμετώπιση της παράνομης μετανάστευσης. Συζητήσαμε τα θέματα που αφορούν τα οικονομικά της μετανάστευσης και κυρίως κάτι που πρέπει να ανοίξει σαν διάλογος, δηλαδή την δημιουργία μιας κλίδας επανεισδοχής, μιας κοινής ευρωπαϊκής αντίληψης, σύμφωνα με την οποία οι παράνομοι μετανάστες θα πρέπει να μοιράζονται ανάμεσα στις χώρες της Ευρωπαϊκής Ένωσης με ποιοτικούς παράγοντες όπως η έκταση, ο πληθυσμός, το ακαθάριστο εθνικό προϊόν. Και τέλος, τους εξήγησα ότι η χώρα μας δεν μπορεί να ψηφίσει τον κανονισμό του Δουβλίνου 2.